Weight loss treatments like Wegovy, Mounjaro, and type 2 diabetes medicines like Ozempic have been all over headlines and social media. In fact, you may have even run into one of my videos on Saxenda or Ozempic. These medicines are so popular that all three injectables are currently in shortages across the country. Retatrutide is similar in that it's a once weekly injection that also changes the way we eat, leading to early feelings of fullness and decreased appetite, which leads to changes in our weight. But is it that much better? In this video, let's discuss retatrutide to see if it has potentially any better results and your chances of getting it, so stay tuned till the end. Also, real quick before we get started, hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm, subscribe if you like this type of content, and let's get started. So what makes retatrutide any different? Well, first off, it has a triple G action. And what do I mean by this? It's known as a triagonist, which is different from the others. We saw with Mounjaro that it has a dual agonist. It has a GLP-1 portion and a GIP portion. Wegovy is just a GLP-1, but retatrutide binds and activates three receptors, the GLP-1, the GIP, and the glucagon receptors. This is what allows retatrutide to induce the glucose-dependent insulin release from the pancreas via GLP-1 receptors, enhance GLP-1 mediated effect through GIP receptors, and increase energy expenditure through glucagon receptors. Which, by the way, is probably how you might end up losing more weight on this one than the others. In the phase 2 clinical trials for Eli Lilly's experimental treatment, which, by the way, they're also the makers of Mounjaro, it shows us that the medication may be even more effective than Ozempic and other predecessors. But let's get into the exciting stuff. In the New England Journal of Medicine, 338 adults with obesity who took retatrutide injections or a placebo for 48 weeks, at the end of the study, the people in the retatrutide group who took the highest dose of 12 milligrams a week lost around 24% of their body weight compared to those in the placebo group, which lost roughly about 2% of their body weight. Also worth mentioning is that the majority of the participants receiving the 12 milligrams dose had lost 20% or more of their baseline weight at 48 weeks, and 26% had lost 30% or more of their original weight, which is very remarkable since the data shows us that retatrutide weight loss is higher than other popular choices. I mean, think about it. To be able to get weight loss in the 20% range, that can now basically compete with things like bariatric surgery in terms of weight loss, which is very exciting. The real question is, if retatrutide comes out on the market, will we finally see the end of the shortage? Or will more and more people end up needing help with managing their weight by the time it comes out? It's a tough question to answer only because obesity keeps on climbing. And while you can't get your hands on retatrutide just yet because it's still experimental, it shows a lot of promise. Right now it's in phase 3, and phase 3 medicines for obesity have a 44% phase transition success rate indication benchmark for progressing into pre-registration. And judging that Eli Lilly already has had their luck with tirzepatide being approved, it means you can start to see it popping up very soon, within a year or two. Right now, what they're making sure of is how well people are able to lose the weight while taking the medicine for longer periods of time. And I'm sure if you've been on any of the GLP-1 agonist medicines, you know by now that lifestyle changes will still be the most important measure that you take. If you don't incorporate things like diet and exercise, the medicines won't be as advantageous to you. I'm actually curious to hear more about how the side effects will be, if they're actually a bit more tolerable than Ozempic's nausea, diarrhea, and constipation and vomiting. If it is, that will be a huge win for Eli Lilly, because it's the side effects that can make some not continue the whole course of the treatment. I'm sure you probably know that. And although Ozempic, Wegovy, and Rybelsus are all Novo Nordisk products, which have obviously dominated the market in the past year, Eli Lilly has its own pipeline of obesity meds too. They're also working on orforglipron, which is a non-peptide GLP agonist that's even easier to produce and package into a pill, making it possibly a lot cheaper and more affordable for some. And this could actually possibly end the shortage altogether, since we will have a lot more options. But I'm actually curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts are about all of this? Let me know in the comments below. Also hit the subscribe button too if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.